Elektor attended Embedded World 2024, the forefront of innovation in electronics. Dive into our insights on newest technologies and upcoming breakthroughs.
I'm here at the Raspberry Pi stand looking at some of the unannounced products. Not exactly secret because thousands of people have been through here. Over here they have the Raspberry Pi AI camera, which has not been officially announced but will be released sooner rather than later, we hope. It's here in a custom 3D printed stand, but notable is that it is connected to a Raspberry Pi Zero, which means the processing is done inside the camera here, on the camera module. So it's not taking up any of the Raspberry Pi's computing power. And look at this. You've got real-time human frame detection on the one hand, and on this one over here, connected to directly to an enclosure for a Raspberry Pi Zero, object detection going. It's running at 30 frames a second on that one. Very smooth, and you've got person, cell phone, microphone. Very cool stuff. So that's just a preview of the Raspberry Pi AI camera, which is not out yet, but will be out sooner or later, and I can't wait to get my hands on it. And again here at the Raspberry Pi stand at Embedded World 2024, and here's another as yet unannounced product, but it's on display to thousands of people here if you're lucky enough to be able to get to Embedded World. It's the 15.6 inch monitor. Now of course you can get portable monitors, but this fits the aesthetic of the Raspberry Pi perfectly. Look at that case and that mouse and that keyboard. Whether you've got a Raspberry Pi 400 or the official Raspberry Pi accessories, this is it. It's the 15.6 inch IPS LCD panel. It runs at 1920 by 1080. 30 hertz as far as I can tell, but I've heard some word of 60 hertz. I'm not too sure. We'll have to clarify that. You've got two speakers, so you've got stereo. It's got a headphone jack, and it runs on USB-C power, so you don't need significant 220 volt or anything like that plugging in. And it's got HDMI as well, naturally. And underneath here, if you take a look in here, there's a port for your cable management. So you don't have to send the cables around the monitor. You just stick them right in underneath. It's got volume, brightness, and power buttons. It's got four Visa inserts on the back. I hope I don't get arrested for touching this. So you can mount it rather easily. And then you see the connections underneath. And a kickstand. And a wall hanger. So yeah, that's a pretty cool product if you're into Raspberry Pi and the Raspberry Pi aesthetic, or just having your complete kit. That's going to be a game changer for you. And we're here at our friends at Espressive at Embedded World 2024, and I'm here with Juraj Michalek. How are you?
Hello, I'm good.
The show been going well for you?
Yeah, the show was extremely nice, and people were asking a lot of questions about our chips. So.
Which is exactly why I'm here, especially the ESP32-P4 that you've launched. Tell us about that.
So ESP32-P4 is the first chip without connectivity. But it's very powerful. It's here.
Let me get out of your way so you can move in there.
So ESP32-P4, which you can see here, is kind of was one of first chips that we have that is without connectivity, but it's very powerful. It has two cores running 400 megahertz. It's a RISC-V. Plus there is one low power core that you can use, for example, for communication with I2C, like low power I2C or low power SPI. The demo kit that you can see here is also featuring connectivity feature with the ESP32-C6, so you can combine it with other chips to gain the connectivity. The chip here also contains PHY, so you are able to connect Ethernet. And a very interesting feature is MIPI, DSI and CSI peripherals, which were added. And with that, we can launch, like this camera, we can wave hand here. And you can see that it has very nice performance.
Yeah, it's very nice. And we've got the MIPI CSI running at 1080p here. It's not only got the most GPIOs, it has 768 kilobytes of RAM. It's two high-powered 400 megahertz cores and one lower power core at 40 megahertz. So it's a very versatile device, and there will most likely be some very interesting applications coming out of that. Thank you so much, Yuri, for sharing that information with me.
Thank you for having me here.
And this is a pretty cool demonstration here at the Texas Instruments booth of the BeagleY AI board. Now, you've heard of Beagle boards before. Here's a new one called the BeagleY AI. And the demonstration runs of a robot arm with a suction cup and an air pipe running through the outside. And what you do basically is you take out an object, say a dog for instance, you drop it in the center of the box, and it detects the object, picks it up, and puts it in the appropriate box. So I believe center box is for dogs. And there you go. You're in the dog box. Over here, for example, there's a fruit. Watch the screen. Detects the fruit, picks it up, and with any luck, drops it in the fruit basket. So yeah, that's the BeagleY AI running some interesting application, and looking at the specs, it's a 64-bit ARM computer designed to simplify physical world interactions. It's built around Texas Instruments AM62X Sitara processors, so it's basically a quad-core ARM A53 human-machine interaction system on a chip. Interesting stuff, as always, at Embedded World 2024.